Hey everybody, welcome back to Cooking with Gual. We took a little break, obviously. You know, my brother passed away and this is a pretty emotional time for me. But we're gonna continue the show. And today we're making tortellini soup and we got some new merchandise. So when you're thinking of ordering out, fuck takeout, you're cooking with Gual, baby.
Cooking with Gual.
You know, so we got Joe too. Joe, turn around, show the camera dude. Joe's the official camera dude. Here, I'm gonna hold it for him.
Damn.
And he's the food taster, my man. All right?
Ready.
So, here we go. We're ready to go. Anyway, I wanted to do a little tribute to Johnny because we talked like about doing this show. And last night while I was thinking, what am I going to do? What am I going to say? I heard his voice and he had one thing to say to me before he left. So I got to show you. It's a little tribute to my brother, but he's still... Your food still sucks. That's what came out of his mouth last night when I was thinking about him. I love you, my brother, but I could still hear your voice saying that. So we're going to keep going, and we're going to start the cooking the tortellini soup.
Yeah,
all right, so this is a pretty easy thing to do, to be honest with you. I'm going to throw some chicken broth in, and I got a few stories to tell as we do it. But the chicken broth goes in, and for some reason, these things, you gotta like squeeze them like you're milking a fucking cow. You know what I mean? To make them, oh,
milking the
yeah,
broth.
There you go. Okay, so that's chicken broth that we put in. What I do with my broth is a little different. I add beef bouillon cubes. And for some reason, it makes the flavor just, I don't know, that much better. You know, I did it one time. I snuck it, like my father was making soup. And I said, would it hurt anybody if I put in a beef bouillon cube? And I did it anyway. And I wanted to see the result. And they were like, wow, this tastes different. What'd you put in there? And my father was like, nothing. It was different. I just made my same soup. Little did he know, Mikey snuck in the beef bouillon cubes. And that's where we're at. And I can't open them because I'm a pain. You know, they're like, you know, it's like opening up a gift at Christmas and you can't wait to get it open. So I put in two... I'm gonna put in three beef bouillon cubes and add some water after. I know this is probably boring watching this do this, but this is what I do. And anyway, and then I add some water and I got, it's usually about a cup for each one. I go a little less because I like the flavor to come out. You know what I was thinking? Every time I make this soup, I think of Tony Soprano. He's lying in the bed with Carmella, right? And Carmella's reading a book, and he says, what are you reading? And she says, I'm reading Chicken Soup for the Soul. And he says, why don't you try reading marinara sauce for your ass? And it just sticks with me every time I make this. So anyway, I put that in, I get that going, and then I add celery, carrots, onion, and my garlic peppers, which I add to everything. Please back off. Yeah, please.
I'm backing off again.
All right, I mean, you know I have this thing, you know, but...
Personal space.
Yeah, it's like, you know what I mean? It's like, all right, my cutting board is like, okay. All right, so I got celery, carrots, onions, garlic peppers, and then I throw in diced tomatoes. Oop, I spilled one. All right. So that's in there. Now, I add spices to it, and this is what I add, and you can add whatever the frig you want. I really don't care what you add. As long as you don't take out and you fucking cook with Gual, this is what you do. I add garlic powder. All right, a nice amount because you want that flavor in there. You know what I mean? A nice coating. I like that word, how you said coating. That's coating. I ran into this girl the other day, right? This is the funniest thing. You ever see those women, they have the painted eyebrows and then they're painted up here and then they have the makeup all the way to the painted eyebrow? You know what I mean? And they come over to you and they could be the nicest person in the world and they could say, I love you with the softest voice. And in your back of your mind, you're going, why the fuck are you yelling at me? Jesus Christ, back off with those eyebrows.
Relax.
So, all right, so garlic powder, onion powder. I put some parsley in. Oh, this is just, I love making soup. Soup is like, I don't know, soup is from the soul. Like, it's when you make someone soup, it's like you're telling them you love them in a liquid form, if that makes sense. You can add chicken to this if you want. You can add whatever you want. I add tortellini. I use crushed red pepper for extra spice there. Oh, I love this. This makes the whole thing. And then I got fresh Parmesan. I get the cheese guy. I've told you about the cheese guy. I'd like to have him over here for a visit one day.
He's a great guy.
I don't know if he wants to be identified on TV. From where he gets the cheese, I don't know. But he's a cheese guy. And anyway, I put a little bit of that in there. All right? So it's easy. This is easy.
Like, you could honestly say he's a made cheese.
He's Brie, if you will. They call him Cheddar Jack, just because that's his name. You know what I mean? So anyway, this is what the broth and everything looks like. And what I do is, honestly, I let this cook until all the vegetables are soft. And then I throw tortellini in there and let them cook right with it. I don't cook the tortellini first, and it's a waste of time. That's stuff boiling. It makes tortellini cook. I mean, hello, use your brain. Anyway, I put it in there. And once this is done and soft, you put the tortellini in there for like 7 or 8 minutes. And it's delicious. I don't know why I've got this thought of this story. I got to tell somebody. I took this girl out one time, right? I don't know why I'm thinking of this shit, because I don't know, my brother, I don't know. Anyway, who I love, it's killing me that he's not here. But I took this girl out one time to a bar, okay? And we were sitting there, and we were minding our own business. It was a big bar, and there was anything could happen in Manchester, New Hampshire, by the way. So we always had, like,
watch your back.
Yeah, like, this is bulletproof, so just so you know. So anyway, I'm sitting there with the girl, we're minding our own business, we're having a good time, a band's playing, it's a lot of fun and everything, and a guy walks in, he's hammered, I mean hammered to the point where it's like everybody in the bar knows what's going on, and he goes up to the bartender and he says, can I have a beer? So the bartender calls over the bouncer, and the bouncer says, listen man, I can't serve you, you've been drinking like for a long time, if you want to have a soda water, whatever, you can sit down. And he was like, no, freak that, and he walked out. So we think the story's over. 15 minutes later, there's another entrance to this bar, and the same guy walks in the door, and he goes up to the same bartender, and he says, can I have a beer? So the bartender, all disgusted, calls over the bouncer again, and the bouncer says, guy, didn't I tell you you can't drink here? And the place went silent, because this guy was a real big dude. And he looked the bouncer straight in the eye and said, what are you working, every fucking bar in Revere?
How do you know you've had a few too many?
Oh, so anyway, I never went out with the girl again, but we still talk about that story. She was an asshole anyway. She wanted me to pay the whole bill, imagine. So anyway, that's what we're going to do. But I did make a preemptive strike here, and this one is all ready. So I wanted you guys to see what it looks like when it's done. We use tri-colored tortellini today. I'm sure if you're colorblind, it doesn't really matter. But this is what I did. So we're going to have Joe test it a little bit, because he's the official tester now that Johnny's not with us anymore. So just bear with me. But this is what it'll look like when it's done. I'm going to put a little broth in there for you, Joey boy.
Oh, yeah.
Broth is good. Broth is for the soul. You know what I'm saying? All right, so there's that. And then I add a little, this is for you, Joe, because I know you like cheese and you like the cheese guy, but that's a different story. And I'm going to take the camera from Joe.
All right.
All right, he's going to be testing it for me. Let's see if
we're
this is any good.
Taste test.
It's 80 degrees out. He's got a Bruins hat on, but whatever. That's, you know what I mean?
It's okay.
It's okay. You know why? He had a rough hair day. All right, come on, Joey. Let me know how it is. Come on.
Give him the Gordon Ramsay taste.
Oh my God, I can see it in your eyes. If he doesn't say good, he's getting kicked out anyway, so what's the difference? I'm just kidding. Come on, tell the truth.
I could go for another bowl. That's good stuff right there. You know what I'm saying?
Fan-fucking-tastic. I'm proud of you, my man.
That's good. See, you know what? It's so good. You know what? I'm going to take another bite.
Here he is. Look at two bites from Joe. It's a two-bite taste tester. I love it. Oh, my God.
I usually only do one, but...
Oh, my God. Does that look good? I can't
killer.
Wait to eat.
That is fantastic. We're going to rate that a solid... 10 out of 10.
Yeah, Joe. Good move, Joe. He gave me a look. Good move. Good move. All right, listen, fantastic. I'm giving Joe the camera back. I got one more thing to say before we go. My sister Cheryl made these for us, and I can't thank her enough. We're actually going to try to start merchandising some Cooking with Gual shit, and it's, fuck, take out your Cooking with Gual, because really, if you watch what I cook, everything takes like 5 minutes. Like, why would you water out? This is easy to do. Make yourself meals. Don't become like blobs, and you're just like, DoorDash, hi, how you doing? This is me again. I'm calling you. They know who you are. It's embarrassing. Stop it.
Cut the shit.
And we will have t-shirts, aprons, and some kitchen napkins like these that with Cooking with Gual. You can contact me if you're interested. If you're not, no big deal. We love wearing them. I love you guys. Thanks for being back on my first episode back from missing my brother John. My heart's broken, but I love you guys, and we're going to continue the show because of him. See you next time on Cooking with Gual.